This PPT has been prepared by referring many sources from the internet, textbooks and reference material. I do not claim any originality in preparing this PPT. In this session, we will discuss about decision making, stages of decision making. Decision making is an essential part of the modern management. Why it is an essential part of the modern management, why it was not important in the earlier part of the life. If you just go back, the human behavior is changing a lot. Earlier, there was a slavery system, barter system. The ability of men were very, very limited and the control was exercised by few select champions. But nowadays, it is entirely different. There is no colonial rule nowadays and we are not waging in wars. We are not interested in expansion. So, what is that we are looking into? We are looking into expansion of the business, not the expansion of the territory. So that is why the decision making has also become an essential part of the modern management. It is the process of choosing among available alternatives like allocation of resources, recruitment and promotion policies, make or buy decisions. These things will get affected as we move on further and newer constraints come into picture. That's why decision making becomes an essential part of modern management, which implies three things. When you are deciding, you are choosing from the available alternatives. You are not choosing randomly, you are choosing with a very logical judgment. It's a rational decision. It's not an ambiguous or vague decision. That is the first thing that we need to understand when we are saying that we are making some decisions. The second thing is the managers have alternatives. When you are choosing means you need to have certain alternatives. It's not that it is only one thing is available and you are choosing that. There is no choice for that. There is a advertisement wherein the mother feeds the son with gulab jamun and the son says, I am the runner up, I got the second prize. And when father asks how many runners were there, only two. So when there are only two, the second one is going to become second place winner. So that is not the meaning of choosing. You have many alternatives. And among them, you are selecting the best one. Managers have a purpose in mind. Why did you select that particular alternative only? Because you have a purpose in mind. And that happened because of your conscious logic or judgment. So, these are the things that we need to remember when we are telling that we are making some decision. So decision means it's not vague, it is logical, choosing with a purpose in mind from a set of alternatives. What are the types of decisions? First one is programmed or non-programmed decisions. Second one is major and minor decisions. Routine and strategic decisions, individual and group decisions, simple and complex decisions. First one is programmed or non-programmed decision. What is a programmed decision? They are made in accordance with some policy procedure. You have a clear-cut policy and you have made a program according to that policy and there is no ambiguity. So that is why it is a written program. When we write a software program, it gets executed according to that policy only, or according to an objective. They are repetitive in nature, and hence easiest for managers to make that decision. It's a routine decision. See, for example, payment of salary. It's a programmed decision. You need not have to change it every month. Ordering of office goods. It's a programmed decision. You need not have to change the procedure every time. Whenever you need to order something, you have to raise the quotation, make a comparative statement, and place the order. So that is why it's called as a programmed decision. Non-programmed decisions are novel and non-repetitive. They are non-repetitive. They won't come here and then, or they won't get repeated. They are one-time decisions. Such decisions have to be tailor-made for the problem. COVID-19 is a non-repetitive problem, and you have to make a decision according to this situation now. And you cannot expect this to happen every year or every month. No, that's a foolish thing. So this will get erased after a few months. And even personal beliefs and attitudes will play a role here. That's also very, very important. Personal beliefs and attitudes. You may just brush it up. This is not a great situation. Let me go ahead. That may be your attitude. And some of the people may feel that, no, this is a very grim situation. Let me take it very seriously. So that kind of attitude will also play a role here. Like expansion decision, product-led difficulties, and you want to expand it to different countries, different states. It's not a program decision, and it won't happen here and then. It won't happen now and then. It has it can happen only on a selected occasion, very rarely. That's why it becomes a non-program decision. Next is major and minor decision. What are these major and minor decision? This is significance of a decision depends on degree of futurity of decision. Where you want to take the company in future. Impact of decision on other functional areas. So if you make a decision on one functional area, say on marketing, how is it going to impact on the operations, finances, other functional areas? Qualitative factors that enter the decision. See, when you make a decision, people may not welcome that decision. Then when it's a qualitative factor, it's not a quantitative factor. You cannot measure the dissatisfaction. It's not a quantitative factor, it's a qualitative factor. Recurrence of a decision. How often it recurs. That's also very, very important. Routine and strategic decisions. Routine, it's a routine decision. Every day, every moment, it keeps on occurring. Like, see, housekeeping decisions, tactical decisions, they're all very supportive to each other. They add efficiency on a continuous basis, like better lighting, better facilities to employees. There are regular things. You need to give increments to employees on a regular basis. That's not a great decision. Whereas strategic decisions are those which require a lengthy deliberation. You need to discuss a lot before taking up a strategic decision, like changing the product line itself. One of the examples I can tell you is that Bajaj scooter had to change from Bajaj scooters to Bajaj bike. It's a strategic decision. It's not a routine decision. Automation of the plant. Now people are moving towards industry 4.0. So now you have to make a very strategic decision. Can you afford that? Because it needs huge investment. But it is need of the day. People have migrated, orders are there, workers are not available. When that is the situation, automation is the solution. So it is a strategic decision. Next type of decisions is individual and group decisions. Individual decisions are normally routine. You need not have to go for a detailed deliberation, detailed discussion with anyone else because they are day-to-day nature. So like the salary administration, you have to pay salary, purchase of some goods, it's also a normal decision. So individually we can take decisions. But certain strategic decisions like see expansion of the company, hiring new personnel, changing the technology, going for automation, they're all very strategic decisions that cannot be handled individually. In that case, normally dielectric method or devil's advocacy will be used, or even group discussion. This dielectric method, it's a philosophical discussion. The word has come from philosophy, wherein many intellectuals will sit together, they keep on arguing, one will speak for their cause and the another one will speak for the other's cause. That is called as a dialectic method. Normally this used to happen during Shankaracharya's time, wherein Shankaracharya wanted to establish the belief of Hindu religion or his religion against the other religions like Buddhism or Jainism. It is not that they are trying to attack each other. They are only trying to tell what is good with their particular thing. So it is not that they are clashing with each other. They are quarreling with each other. It's only to understand each and every alternative in a better way. That is the main intention of dialectic method. They used to respect each other to a very high extent. Even after somebody felt that, yeah, his argument is better, that did not mean that the other person is an idiot or he doesn't know anything. No, that's not the reason. In dialectic method, people used to decide, these people have a better scope of argument, that's all. But both of them were equally given high respect. The devil's advocacy is also something like that, wherein even though I know that this is a good decision, I do not accept it. I normally go on asking for clarification, criticize it, and why do I do that? Because if I accept it as it is without questioning, at a later stage I may come up with a particular flaw or a problem. At that point of time, it would be very difficult to repair it. So that is why I use devil's advocacy. These two methods are proactive methods and they are preferred than reactive methods. Group decisions have the following advantages, like say increased acceptance by those affected, because it's a collective decision, it's not an individual decision. Easier coordination. You can coordinate very easily because you are sitting in a group and discussing. Better communication in a group. More information is processed because many intellectuals are sitting together and discussing. So more information is processed there. Whereas certain disadvantages are also there, like takes more time, obviously, because each one of them feel that they know better. And they try to propose their own method and they try to see that their method is implemented. That's why it takes more time. Yes, can be indecisive. This is very, very important. It can sometimes it will become indecisive. Why it will become indecisive? Because people will think that their plan should be implemented. The credit should come to them only. When that is the case, obviously, it could be indecisive. Groups can compromise. That is another disadvantage. Many a times what will happen, a very good plan gets eliminated because of a dominant person in the group and it's a compromise. Groups can be dominated. That's what I was talking. And if it is dominant, some of the decisions gets compromised and you may not have a real proper decision to come to the fore and to be implemented. Next type is simple and complex. simple decisions. Some of them could be routine, day to day, they're simple decisions. While some of them are complex, like strategic decisions, they're all very complex decisions. Routine decisions, a problem is simple, with high degree of certainty of the outcome, you know that. So it's a routine decision. Judgmental decision, problem is simple, but the outcome is not certain. You need to make some discussion and then take that decision, then it becomes a judgmental decision. Analytical decision, problem is complex. You need to analyze the problem itself. Okay, but if you analyze the problem and take that decision, you are sure that this is going to be outcome. So here the problem is complex, but the outcome is certain. The last one is adaptive decision. Problem is complex and the outcome is also not certain. So under that particular situation, we call it as adaptive decision. We are adapting to a new situation wherein some problem has to be dealt with and some strategic decision need to be taken place. Steps in rational decision making. Recognizing the problem, deciding the priorities among problems. There is a problem and all problems should not be given equal priorities. You have to decide about which problem should be given first priority and that problem must be solved first. Diagnosing the problem, why that problem has occurred, you have to diagnose. Developing alternate courses of action, how to overcome this problem, develop alternate courses of action for that. Measuring and comparing the consequences of the alternative solutions. You have to measure and compare, if I take this course of action, what are going to be consequences? This course of action, what are going to be consequences? And comparing all these things, you have to arrive at a decision. Finally, converting this decision into an effective and action, follow-up action. So you are implementing now. You have selected the alternate course of action. You have measured and compared the consequences of alternative solutions. Now it is the stage of implementation and follow-up action with a feedback mechanism. This is how it occurs, recognizing the problem and deciding the priorities, then is the diagnosing the problem, developing the alternate solutions, measuring and comparing the consequences, next stage is decision, implementation and follow-up with a feedback. Recognizing the problem. What is this recognizing the problem? The problem is believed to be existing when there is a deviation from past experience. Last month you had 100 cars sold. This month you are able to sell only 10 cars. That means there is a problem. Problem is existing because you are not able to meet the sales target. There is deviation from the plan. You had a plan of selling 1,000 cars in 1 year, but you could sell only, you are not able to meet that plan because of the prevailing situation. There is a deviation from the plan. That will also say that some problem has happened. Problem brought by others. COVID situation, we did not bring that problem, we did not want that problem to happen. Someone else have brought that problem and we are facing that. Competitors outperform the organization, our competitors outperform us, they overtake us, then it's a problem. We were kings at one point of time, but our competitors have overtaken us now. We are falling back. At one point of time, Micromax was number one mobile sold in India. But where is Micromax now? Few years ago, Nokia was the number one mobile manufacturing company. Where is Nokia now? So these are the situation which say that there are certain problems. Second stage in decision making is deciding priorities among problems. How do we decide about the priorities in problems? We need to understand that all problems are not alike. While some of the problems can be solved by the subordinates, workers itself, while some of them have to be passed on to higher level. And some of the problems can be solved very easily and requires hardly any time and hardly any attention, while some of the problems require higher level of effort and requires more attention and requires more effort and time. To take these decisions, a matrix of importance versus urgency will be very helpful. What is that matrix of importance and urgency versus urgency? It's how it looks. There are four quadrants, and the first quadrant is, say, highly important and highly urgent. The second quadrant is highly important but not so urgent. The third quadrant is highly urgent but not so important. And the fourth quadrant is not urgent, not important. So where should I do first? First, I should give concentration to this first quadrant, and I have to do that work, complete that work. Once I complete that work, then comes the second quadrant work. What is that? Not urgent but important. I can plan. I can start planning towards execution of these works. They are important, but they are not very, very urgent. Okay. So that's why I can start planning towards these things. Then is the third quadrant, which says very urgent but not important. What I can say that, so it's not an important decision. So high level of high degree of decision making is not required, but it is urgent, normal decision, delegate it. Give it to someone else. You need not have to scratch your mind over such decisions which are not important. You have to concentrate more on this quadrant 1 and quadrant 2 decisions. Concentrate on these two things. You can delegate these things. So, when it is urgent but not important, we can delegate. And the last one is not urgent, not important, eliminate it or postpone it. You need not have to worry about it. It's not an important decision. It's not an urgent decision. Eliminate it. Postpone it for next year. Postpone it for another few months. So this is the meaning of urgency versus importance. This is a very important thing, and I suggest you, even for your day-to-day life, you follow this. When you follow this, your life is going to be better. The third stage is diagnosing the problem. The symptoms of a problem may be misleading, and symptoms of many problems look alike, and you have to diagnose it properly. See, for example, even a doctor diagnoses a disease in a very clear way. For example, typhoid, malaria, dengue, corona, all these things have a common symptom. Like, the symptoms are headache, cold, cough, fever. So I cannot decide that if you have cold and cough, you have been infected with coronavirus. No. Any virus infection, viral fever, it's the same. So you have to take a systems approach in diagnosing the problem. You have to look into all aspects. That's why an experienced doctor will ask so many questions, pinpointed questions, before diagnosing the disease. Similarly, a manager should also look into all aspects related to the problem. The fourth stage is development of alternate courses of action. What we need to remember is that there is no only one way of doing things. There are many ways of doing things, and every problem has some alternative solutions. For example, recession. To overcome, we can remove employees, reduce their salary, cut their extra facilities, reduce the working shifts. These are the some of the decisions that companies have taken. Some of them have reduced their salary at 50% salary. They are running the show. They have reduced the working shifts from 3 shifts. They have reduced to 1 shift. They have asked the workers to come on 50% of the employees to come on first 3 days of the week and remaining 50% on next 3 days of the week. These are the different alternate courses of action to meet the current situation. See, for example, different stages of developing alternate courses of action is saturation. Managers get familiarity with the problem. Deliberation, looking a problem with multiple viewpoints. You are looking with a multiple viewpoints, 360 degree view. You are following a 360 degree approach. Incubation, thinking about the problem calmly. You are in an incubation center. That means everything is in a serene environment. Illumination, a flash insight may take place to about the solution for that particular problem. Accommodation, refining ideas to a usable proposal. You have a proposal and you have to accommodate for that, refine it. The best technique is brainstorming, wherein different people sit together, discuss, come up with ideas, flash ideas. At that point of time, they do not decide about whether it is feasible or not. They keep on flashing ideas so that as many ideas can come into picture. The fifth stage is measuring and comparing the consequences of alternative solutions. Compare quality and acceptability of various solutions. In the previous stage, we had a brainstorming session wherein we did not think about the feasibility. In this stage, we start discussing about the feasibility of the solutions. We compare the quality, whether it's a quality decision or not, and whether it can be accepted or not. Such decisions will be taken here. In such situation where there is no information, then pilot testing can be done. Converting the decision into effective and action and follow-up action. Employees must be communicated about the decision taken. They must be taken into account. They must be taken into confidence before we proceed any further. Employees' acceptance is a must. We should not neglect their decisions, neglect their behavior and attitude. We should give them due respect. Follow-up action is necessary. That is, feedback mechanism is necessary for necessary corrections. Difficulties in decision making. What are the difficulties? Incomplete information. Many a times we may not get the complete information. Then decision will not be correct. Unsupporting environment. People may not support you. Management may not support you. You may have a good decision, but management may not support you. Workers may not support you. Non-acceptance by subordinates. Ineffective communication. You did not communicate to your higher authority properly. That is another difficulty in decision making. You know everything, but if you do not communicate it properly, what is the use? That's why we keep on telling you communication is very, very important. You need to have a proper communication. Communication classes must be attended. When we take some communication classes, many of the students neglect that. That should not happen. Communication is a very critical situation. Very critical decision that you need to make. Incorrect timing, when you are taking that decision, that's also very, very important. At this point of time, you cannot expect the company to invest in crores. So whatever may be the decision, you have to tell that at nick of time, at a proper time.